I would like to invite you to a guitar concert performed by students of University of Music in Łódź. During the concert, you will hear pieces composed by two Australian guitarists, Ross Edwards and Philip Houghton. Philip Houghton was born in 1954. He was a relative latecomer to classical music. His early musical interests were rock, jazz, and folk music. He spent a year studying painting at Parham Technical College and then decided to break off his fine art studies to concentrate on music. Houghton studied guitar for a couple of years. His only formal training in composition was a period of private study with Helen Gifford in 1982. However, he spent much time studying scores, recordings, books, and discussing with many composers and musicians. Houghton wrote music for acoustic and electronic media, theater, film, and dance. He died in 2017. That's how he remembered his beginnings with music. When I was 9, I got a guitar for Christmas. I didn't like it, so I used it as a cricket bat until it got smashed by a fast ball. 6 years later, I found it in the garage, glued it up, and put one piece of fishing line on it. Chords were difficult, but when I found out that I could play riffs like Wild Thing, I began wondering about the other 5 strings. My world changed when I heard Jimi Hendrix and later John Williams, Alirio Diaz, and Julian Bream. Before that, it had been the voice of John Lennon, Bugs Bunny cartoons, Rain on the Roof, cicadas, crickets, and radio static. The second composer, Ross Edwards, was born in 1943 in Sydney. His distinctive sound world reflects his interest in deep ecology and his belief in the need to reconnect music with elemental forces, as well as restore its traditional association with ritual and dance. Edwards has been working as a freelance composer and lecturer since 1980. Before that, he worked in a Sydney Conservatorium School of Composition. The concert will begin with 2 pieces from Black Willow Caprices composed by Ross Edwards for Timothy Kane. We will hear 2 parts, Andantino Molto Flessibile Sibile and Vivace. According to the composer's opinion, these are light but intricate pieces, a song and Australian dance, Maninia. The music will be performed by Kalina Polańska. Afterwards, Rafał Siedlecki will perform 3 of 5 exotic studies composed by Philip Houghton for John Champ. Here are the names of the parts. Prelude, Orange Blossom Harvest, Romance, Long Deep Waltz, and Obeyed Kingsfisher Lake. That's how Philip Houghton expressed his thoughts about the pieces. I've taken a little poetic license and called them exotic to indicate that they are not traditional studies, in the sense that each study should be focused on one only particular technique at a time. The pieces are melodic and each has a story. Next piece by Philip Houghton is called Kinkachu, I Love You, and will be performed by Katarzyna Gogola. Premiere of this particular composition took place in 1998 in Monteville, Queensland. We will also hear 2 parts of the Goldfish Suite, Red Goldfish and Yellow Goldfish. The suite brings color, atmosphere, and timing into sharp focus. Moreover, the music finely reflects the movement and color of goldfish. 2 parts of this suite will be performed by Claudia Kukla.
Thank you.
In this part of the concert, you will hear other pieces composed by Philip Houghton. The first one is called God of the Northern Forest. It was written for a former teacher of Houghton, Sebastian Jorgensen, who gave the premiere of this piece at the 1990 Melbourne International Guitar Festival. The composer drew inspiration from his teacher's national heritage and childhood experiences of growing up in Eltham, Victoria. Musical ideas on how to express these two contrasting images are based on interaction of the themes. Maksym Niewczas will be the performer. Next piece was written by Houghton for Carlos Bonnell. It's called Ophelia, a Haunted Sonata. It consists of 5 parts: Fear and the Angel, Suffering and Madness, Am I But a Dream of Shadow, Chant of the Flower Moon, Water, Memories, Halls of Ghost, Wash Away, and Death with Moons in Your Hair. While explaining the source of inspiration for this piece, Philip Houghton used to say, "Another powerful influence on me, besides from Shakespeare text, was the painting Ophelia from 1852, painted by artist John Millais. It shows Ophelia drowning in a river surrounded by a garland of wildflowers. Looking beyond the beautiful maiden aspect of the legend, I was drawn to the person who was Ophelia and to what she symbolized. The struggle at a spiritual and psychological level of what it means to be a human. In this light, the music may be a journey through an emotional landscape. Haunted Sonata will be performed by Kalina Polańska."
Thank you. Thank you.
The final piece of this concert is called Suite of Six Trios by Philip Houghton. These are the parts of this composition: Obeid, Morning Song; Rondo, The Spring I'll Be Flooded; Becoming Water; Impromptu, Dance of Faith; Relic; and Initiation, Homage to Duchamp, Nosferatu Descending Staircase. Suite of Six Trios was written in 1981 to celebrate the opening of chapel at the Mont Salvat Artist Colony in Eltham, Victoria. Originally, the piece was scored for lute and two guitars. It was premiered by lutenist Roger Treble, guitarists Evangelos Karavitis and Sebastian Jorgensen, and Steve Warner guesting on bouzouki in the fifth part. The suite is melodic and quite rustic in nature. The music reflects medieval, pre-Raphaelite, and Impressionist influences and recalls a vanishing world that continues to beacon us through nature, myth, legend, folk art, and music world.